Hello all, myself Suresh Kumar. Today I'm going to show you the timer and multitasking concept in hardware. I already take that class in our PIC class, PIC tutorials, but we can't understand in simulator multitasking concepts. In our simulators, simulator is working good, but my screen recorder cam studio doesn't take that much speed per frame per seconds, so that's why you can't see that. I can see it because I can see that monitor actions, but the screen recorder video only you see it in my class. So you can't see it because that cam studio taking 2 frames per second, so 500 milliseconds per frame, so you can't see it because my hardware, which means the LED blinking very fast, very speed, I can make it up to 15 microsecond to I can blink 1 millisecond or 2 microsecond, 100 microsecond, 110 microsecond, 17 microsecond, whatever I want in calculation, in timer calculation, and that formula. Now I am going to show you hardware. In this hardware you can see it very well because my web camera is HD webcam, so it will be take that frames, high speed frame. I think it will be take a real video, a real what's going on in hardware, so you can understand that multitasking concept in a single core processor, 8-bit core processor. You can see it right now single processor microcontroller doing a different speed of different tasks in a different speed. You can see it right now. I had one PIC3. This is connected with my laptop. This is PIC3. This is for programming these microcontrollers, PIC microcontrollers, only for PIC microcontrollers only. This PIC3 is highly recommended. PIC3, PIC2 also there, ICD2 also there, ICD3 also there. Those all are debuggers. This PIC3 acts as a debugger also and a programmer also. Programmer, we can program it in our PIC microcontroller. This is PIC16F87A microcontroller. I had a simple development board here. This is comes from NSK Electronics. Thanks for NSK Electronics. And this is PIC3. I'm using PIC3. This is my programmer. I can also use this device as a debugger also. Debugger means what? We can check that line by line and logic errors line by line while running this microcontroller. In this PIC3 has another feature, that is programmer to go mode, which means you can program without your computer. If your programmer is right, then upload it into this PIC3, that program, that hex file into this PIC3, then change in this programmer as programmer to go mode. It has a 3 mode. One is programmer mode and another one is debugger mode, and also it act as a programmer to go mode. If you set a programmer to go mode in this PIC3, then you don't want that PC or laptops for editing the code. If you once add that hex file, then you can take this from USB and put in your pocket and go in your industrial side and then provide you for this PK3 power. You can power this power this PK3, then you can make it as a programmer. You just plug in your microcontroller with the ICSP connection, and this is ICSP connection, circuit sealed programming, and then just it has a push button. You just press this button, then inside our program already we are uploaded our program. That programmer is going to this ICSP pin, then you, which means you can program it without your computer. If you already program in this PK3, then you can upload it a lot of microcontrollers, same program, same file, which means you can upload the hex file into this microcontroller without a computer. That is called programmer to go mode. So I had a programmer PK3, it has three functions. And I connected the ICSP connection between this microcontroller and PK3. Here I am showing right now the LEDs are connected with my D0 pin and D1 pin. You can see it. You can see it. D0 and D1 pin. You got it. Just connected with directly connected with this LED. You can see it. This working good. You can see right now. In this video, in this, what do you think about right now? This D1. This is the D1 pin. And this is the D0 pin. This is blinking every 1 second, which means 1000 milliseconds. I am just put into my super loop, while loop. So this is blinking repeatedly, and this you can understand that right now multitasking purpose. This is this LED blinking different speed, and also this is also blinking different speed. That time, if this LED doesn't affect this task, this LED, this task doesn't affect this task, which means two tasks, different tasks. One is subroutine and another one is main task. This is main task, this is our supporting task. This is a different speed, this is a different speed. I'm just polling this LED, this task, and I'm just, this is my timer 2 LED, timer 2. I'm using timer 2 in this concept. We can use it timer 0 and timer 1 also. I'm just using timer 2 because that is a very good response. Another 2 is also good, but this is a good, it has a post-scalar also. You can see it right now. This task doesn't affect this task. You got it. It is hard to understand, but this task, this is blinking the same speed. That time this is also blinking same speed, which means two tasks running simultaneously, running parallelly. If you polling this in this two LED in your main loop, that time if you make it, you can't make it. If you wait for that program is working line by line, so that time this LED doesn't glow like this, blink like this, different speed. If this LED blinking, that time this is switched off. This is doesn't do anything, or I'm using toggle function. So if it is blinking, if it blink, that time the program will to move, going to move in this pin. It is continuously glowing. After that, if this task is completed, then come to here. And this task is complete, then come to here. But see right now, This is blinking a different speed. This is blinking a different speed. Continuously blinking, continuously, repeatedly, same speed is maintained. This task doesn't affect this task, and this task doesn't affect this task. This task. I got it. I hope you understand. This is single core, na? This is single core. This is single 8-bit processor, 8-bit microcontroller, doing a different speed. In the subroutine part, in our program, you can give the lot of tasks with in your logic thinking. You can give it, you can make it 100 or 1000 or 10,000 tasks with this microcontroller. I didn't check yet 10,000 tasks, but I can I just check it and 15 tasks or 16 tasks in this subroutine part. I had a 3 timer. I'm making a 1 timer for 100 or 16 or 17 tasks. See that I had a main program and also I had a subroutine task. That is 16. So 17 tasks different simultaneously running with different speed. So I can check it. I can use it. This process microcontroller for any high speed applications, different kind of industrial applications. I hope you understand. But I understand well. How can I show it? Okay, I will take it in my real-time applications in industrial side. I'm using the same concept in I implemented in the same concept in my industrial side. There is also working timer two, also timer one, different speed, single core making different tasks without any other task affected. Thank you. I think thank you. I hope you understand. Please subscribe my channel for these kind of videos. I'm not making a class right now. I share my experience to you. So that's why I try to show in this concept. Working in my industrial side, in my industrial products, how this timer is working, we can use it in industrial side or real time. Okay, thanks for watching. Please subscribe my channel. Thank you.